Hi guys, welcome back to Chinta DIY. Today's video I'll be showing you how to crochet a simple rib cardigan with pockets. It is really easy and friendly for beginners. And now let's get into the video. First, we are going to make the front side of the cardigan. For this cardigan, we are working on the length way. For you guys that want the cardigan longer, please add more foundation chain. And if you guys want your cardigan bigger, please add more rows at the shoulder part before you make the V-neck line. To begin, make a slip knot. And chain 70. It is equal 16 inches length. Like I said, if you guys want your cardigan longer, please add more chains. After you reach your desired fit, next we are going to make single crochet. For row 1, skip 1 chain and make single crochet into the next chain. To make single crochet, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. So now you have two loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all the loops. Keep repeating this into every chain until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, next for row 2, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet but into the back loop of the stitch only. Keep making single crochet back loop only into every stitch until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, for the next row, we are going to repeat row 2 until you reach row 31. It is equal 7 inches width. It's the measurement of my shoulder. And for you guys want to make your cardigan bigger, please add more rows at the shoulder part. Thank you. So this is what the front side of the cardigan looks like after you reach row 31. This is how I'm measuring on my body. Place it on your shoulder. And for you guys who want to make it smaller, please make less row. Next, we are going to make the V-neck line. Next, continue from where your last stitch is. For row 32, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet back loop only into every stitch until you have 9 last stitches. Then we are going to make single crochet decrease. To make single crochet decrease, insert the hook into the back loop of the stitch, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 2 loops on your hook. Then continue insert the hook into the next loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, repeat this to the next loop. And now you got 4 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all the loops. And this is how we made single crochet 3 together. And for the 6 stitches remain, we are going to skip it. Next, for row 33, chain 1, turn your work. Skip 1 stitch and make single crochet back loop only into the next stitch. Keep making single crochet back loop only into every stitch until the end of the row. For row 34, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet back loop only into every stitch until you have 3 last stitches. Then we are going to make single crochet decrease again. After you had 3 last stitches remain, then we are going to make single crochet 3 together like we did in row 32. Next, for row 35, repeat row 33. For the next row, we are going to repeat row 34 and row 33 until you reach row 49. It means that we are going to make 1 row with single crochet decrease and 1 row without decrease. And here what the front side of the cardigan looks like after you reach row 49. And for you guys who want to make the V-neck line more deeper, please add more decreasing row. After you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Please make the second side by repeat the same thing like the first side. Next, we are going to make the back part of the cardigan. Start with 70 chains and make single crochet back loop only for 31 rows. It is the same measurement as the front side, which is where the shoulder part. So for the front shoulder part, we have 31 rows. And for the back part, we also made 31 rows the same. And next, we are going to make decrease for the back neckline. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is. For row 32, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet back loop only into every stitch until you have 3 last stitches. Then we are going to make single crochet decrease. Next, for row 33, chain 1, turn your work, skip 1 stitch, and make single crochet back loop only into every stitch until the end of the row. For the next row, we are going to repeat row 32 and row 33 until you reach row 37. It means that we are going to make 6 rows of decreasing stitch. So we have 6 rows of decreasing stitch. Next, for row 38 until row 65, chain 1, turn your work, and make single crochet back loop only into every stitch until the end of the row. So start from row 38, we stop making decreasing stitch, just make no more single crochet back loop only. And this is what the back part looks like after you reach row 65. Next, we are going to make increasing stitch. Start from row 66, chain 1, turn your work, and make single crochet back loop only into every stitch until you have one last stitch. Then we are going to make increase by make 3 single crochet into the same loop. After you got 3 single crochet into the same stitch, next, for row 67, chain 1, turn your work, and make increase by make 2 single crochet into the same stitch. After you had 2 single crochet into the same stitch, then keep making single crochet back loop only into every stitch until the end of the row. Keep repeating row 66 and row 67 until you reach row 71, then I will meet you back again. So after you reach row 71, you must have 6 rows of increasing stitch. It is the same number like the decreasing row. Next, for row 72 until row 102, chain 1, turn your work, and make single crochet back loop only into every stitch until the end of the row. So start from row 72, we stop making increasing stitch, just make no more single crochet row. for the measurement from row 72 until row 102, it is equal 7 inches length. So for this both shoulder part, you must have 31 rows the same. After you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what the back part of the cardigan looks like. And for you guys that make this cardigan bigger or smaller, so here how we measuring the back part of the cardigan. So for the back shoulder part measurement, we got from the front shoulder part. So for my front shoulder part have 31 rows, and for the back shoulder part must be have 31 rows the same. And then I made decreasing stitch for 6 rows. So 31 rows plus 6 rows, it is equal 37 rows. And for the front part, I have 49 rows in total, include the decreasing row. So 37 rows of the back part minus the 49 rows of the front part, we still have 12 rows remain. And for the other side, we also minus the same. And 12 rows plus the other 12 rows, it is equal 24 rows. And the 24 rows, it is the measurement of this middle part. And then we have to add 4 rows more. In total, you must have 28 rows. And why we have to add 4 rows more? Because the front part, we still have to put some edges, which is where the button part. And this is how I'm measuring the back part of my cardigan. Next, we are going to make the sleeves. Start with 70 chains and make single crochet back loop only for 54 rows. If you guys want your sleeve longer, please add more chains. And if you guys want your sleeve bigger, please add more rows. Next, we are going to connect the front part and the back part of the cardigan together. To begin, attach the yarn into both sides loop. And chain 1. Next, we are going to make slip stitch. To make slip stitch, insert the hook into both sides loop. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. Keep repeating this into every stitch until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, repeat the same thing to the other side. For For the next part, we are going to connect the sleeves into the cardigan. Fold the sleeve into two pieces and use stitch marker to mark at the middle part of the sleeve. Then place the stitch marker at the shoulder part. And make slip stitch both sides together. After you have connected everything together, then turn the cardigan right side out. Next, we are going to make the white edge at the bottom of the cardigan. So for the first row, I'm still using the same color and I'm using 3.5 mm hook. To begin, attach the yarn and chain 1. Next, for row 1, make single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. Remember, for this small loop, we are going to skip it. We only working single crochet into this line. And this line. For the last stitch, after you got two loops on your hook, then drop the purple yarn and bring the white yarn. Yarn over and pull through two loops. Don't forget to cut off the purple yarn. Next, for row 2 until row 6, chain 1, turn your work. And make single crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. Thank you. After you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, we are going to make the wide edge around this neckline and the front part of the cardigan. But first, we have to make single crochet around this neckline by using the same color. To begin, attach the yarn and chain 1. Then make single crochet into every stitch around the neckline until you reach the other corner. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the corner, then we are going to make slip stitch, chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, attach the yarn into the corner part and chain 1. For row 1, make single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into every stitch around until the end of the row. After you reach the end of the row, so for row 3, we are going to make the buttonholes. First, count 4 stitches away from the corner and mark at the 5th stitch. Then count 11 stitches and mark at the 12th stitch. Repeat this for 2 more times. So for this cardigan, I make 4 buttonholes. Next, for row 3, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into every stitch until you reach the stitch marker. After you reach the stitch near stitch marker, then chain 3. After you got 3 chains, then skip 3 stitches and make single crochet into the 4th stitch. Make sure that your button fit into the button holes. If you guys use smaller button, please make less chain by chain 2 or chain 1. Keep making single crochet into every stitch until you reach the stitch marker. Then we are going to repeat the same thing. After you reach the corner, then continue make single crochet into every stitch around until the end of the row. For row 4 and row 5, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. After you reach row 5, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, we are going to make the white edge around the wrist. To begin, attach the yarn and chain 1. For row 1, we are going to make single crochet decrease by making single crochet 2 together. Keep making decreasing stitch around the sleeve until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. Thank you. After you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch into the chain 1 stitch to connect the row. Next, for row 2, chain 1 and make single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the chain 1 stitch, then make slip stitch. For row 3 until row 6, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into every stitch around until the end of the row, then make slip stitch to connect the row. After you reach row 6, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, use the knitting needle to weave in. For the next part, we are going to sew the buttons. Next, we are going to make the pocket. Start with 13 chains and make single crochet back loop only for 18 rows. And next, we are going to make single crochet around this pocket. To begin, chain 1 and make single crochet into every stitch around. Remember, for this small loop, you always skip it. So for this line, we are not going to make single crochet into it. And for the last stitch, we are going to switch to the white yarn. Next, for row 1 until row 5, chain 1, turn your work, and make single crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. Thank you. After you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. So this is what the pocket looks like. Please repeat the same thing to the other side. Next, we are going to sew the pocket into the cardigan. To make sure that the pocket placed on the same spot, I count 25 stitches and mark it. And 5 rows from the white edge. To make sure that the bottom part of the pocket stays straight, I count 6 stitches in every row. For the white yarn, I use for sewing the white part. And now your ribbed cardigan is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.